When you look at this keyboard, the first thing you notice is that the numeric keypad is on the left side. So you may think this was designed for the approximately 10% of the population who are left-handed, but that was actually not the case, or at least not the primary intent of the company who made this, called Evoluent. If we look at the back of this, there it says, mouse-friendly keyboard, part number KB1-SB, made in China, patents pending. And there's somebody's signature engraved into it. It looks like Jack L. I don't know if that was the person who designed this or what. If you look on the website of this company, they say the whole reasoning for this keyboard design is that these days, most people use the mouse more often than they use their numeric keypad. So rather than having the mouse all the way over here with the numeric keypad in between, with this design, with the home row in the same position as on a standard keyboard, your mouse can be quite a bit closer to your home row keys, making the mouse a shorter reach and more convenient to use. And then for the times you do need a numeric keypad, it's still over here on the left. You can also see it rearranges some of the other keys to save space, similar to many laptop keyboards. In fact, the key feel is very similar to laptop keyboards of about 10 years ago, before they all switched over to chiclet keyboards. And despite the rather short key travel, it is surprisingly tactile, similar to old ThinkPad keyboards. So if you're a fan of those, you might like this kind of keyboard. It has additional shortcut keys up here for web browsing, your media player controls, volume up and down and mute, wake, sleep, and power, and a My Computer button. One unusual thing is that it has the one Windows key over here, but there's no matching right-click menu key on the other side. Where you would expect it to be is the delete and insert keys. So it's missing that right-click menu button key, if anybody actually uses that. And curiously, there's a second delete key on the left side here, which is the first time I've actually seen that on a keyboard. And it actually has a little finger stop on it, as well as the control key, something you don't normally see, as do the end and page down keys. And on the numeric keypad, you can see, in addition to the little finger stop on the 5 key, has a little nubs on the 7, 9, 1, and 3 keys. So whoever designed this keyboard really liked these little bumps on the keys to help you find where you are when you're typing. But one thing about this keyboard you may not like is how flat it is. Not only the keys themselves, but the entire case is pretty much flat as well. And there are no flip-out feet on the back to raise it up. You just get these little rubber pads. So when you have it lying down on the table, it may not be the most comfortable typing position if you're used to a keyboard that's more raised up at the back. You may have to prop something under there to raise it up. And if you're right-handed, you'll probably find it rather awkward to have the numeric keypad on the left side. You're probably not used to typing on it with your left hand, and if you want to use your right hand, you either have to cross your arms or you have to shift your whole arm over to reach it over here instead of over on the right side where it normally is. And if you want to gain that same benefit of having the mouse closer to your home row without the awkward positioning of the numeric keypad on the left side, you could just use an ordinary 10 keyless keyboard. Probably not one as colorful as this, but they make all kinds of varieties of 10 keyless keyboards. They're very popular these days. So you can still have your mouse close to your home row, and then when you need a numeric keypad, you can just get a separate one and put it on the right of the mouse. So you can have your mouse in the middle, numeric keypad over on the right where it's still convenient to reach if you're right-handed, and your keyboard over here. Nonetheless, if you're still interested in the Evoluent mouse-friendly keyboard, or what they now call the reduced reach right-hand keyboard, I'll give you a typing sample of this keyboard.
I like an escalator, man, because an escalator can never break. It can only become stairs. All right. There would never be an escalator temporarily out of order sign. Only an escalator temporarily stairs. Sorry for the convenience.